The human voice is created by air passing between the vocal folds, causing them to vibrate, resulting in sound waves. The vibrating vocal folds can be easily visualized with an endoscope passed through the nose. With such a top-down view, the vocal folds appear to be V-shaped thin membranes that vibrate against each other. However, such a simplistic two-dimensional view is actually incorrect. Rather, when the vocal folds are seen in cross-section, instead of being a thin band-like structure, they are actually a wedge-shaped triangle. Furthermore, when the vocal folds vibrate against each other, there is both a horizontal and vertical component. With phonation, the thyroarytenoid muscle first sets the vocal folds into a closed position. The vocal fold vibration itself is then due to the vocal fold membrane that overlies and moves freely over the muscle. Subglottic air pressure builds up below the vocal folds as air is pushed up from the lungs. The minimum air pressure required for initiation of vocal fold vibration is known as the phonation threshold pressure. The higher this pressure, the higher the potential for vocal hyperfunction. As the subglottic air pressure increases, it overcomes the resistance of the closed vocal folds, causing them to open slightly beginning from the lower margin. As the air pressure continues to move upward, more of the vocal folds open up until it reaches the superior margin, at which point, air is fully released between the vocal folds and pushes on up towards the pharynx. At this moment, air flow increases and accelerates as it passes the glottis, resulting in a pressure drop due to the Bernoulli effect. This pressure drop causes the vocal fold membranes to be pulled back together. As the lower edges of the vocal fold membranes come back together, they drag the upper edges to the midline since they are connected and share the same elastic properties. It is at this point that full closure of the vocal folds occur. The cycle is then repeated. It should be emphasized that this vocal fold oscillation is inherently asymmetrical, with a lag between the bottom and top edges of the vocal folds coming together. The vocal fold membrane or cover moves freely and separately from the vocal fold muscle as a result of the action of the air flowing through the glottis. This movement is wave-like, like a ripple over the surface of a pond, and it is known as the mucosal wave. Please keep in mind that the prior animation was exaggerated for clarity. In reality, the thyroarytenoid muscle does not move during vocal fold vibration as shown in this simpler animation. Note how the vocal fold membrane moves freely over the muscle. As the pitch increases, the vocal fold vibration speeds up as well as narrows together. The three-dimensional components of actual human vocal fold vibration can only be observed on high-definition, high-speed video recordings. Here is a video, courtesy of Dr. Eric Forrest. Please note that the video is silent.